and gentlemen. I treasure a memory, ladies and gentlemen. When I was a boy, about 7.5 years old, when a great man and a great artist visited our home and not only inspired me to want to become a musician, but also inspired my parents to give me the encouragement that I needed. His name was Paderewski. And a few months ago, I had the great thrill of paying tribute to Paderewski in Madison Square Garden in New York City. He was the only other pianist ever to give a concert there. And I presented some of the highlights of his program at Madison Square Garden. His program he played in 1932. For all the many people who treasure his greatness in their memory, as I do, I would like to play some of the highlights of Paderewski's 1932 concert at Madison Square Garden, in which he played the beautiful music of Chopin.
Thank you.
much, everyone. You know, I'm often asked, what is my favorite kind of music? And I suppose if I had to really single it out, I would choose American music above all the rest because it has so many different and interesting variations. In fact, there's one kind of American music that I wish I could perform, but I just don't seem to have the ability to do it justice, so I leave it alone. However, this music enjoys its tremendous popularity, and I'm sure there are many fans of this music here tonight, and I would like to have you hear some of it, whether I do it or not. It so happens this music, which we refer to as hillbilly music, has come to my attention due to the fact that someone wrote a hillbilly song about me, of all people. And I thought you would enjoy hearing it, so I made arrangements to have a young man come out here who does this kind of music and sings it real well, and I thought with your little encouragement, he would be only too glad to come out and sing the song for us. How about it? Okay. You know, George, I have a sneaking suspicion that he can't hear what I'm saying out here, so I'll go and get him, and you can play his introduction while I go and get him, huh? Okay? Hi, how are you? Had to get in the mood. I'm not ready yet. Something's happening, I feel. Okay. Hey, Liberace, I'd like to know where you got that smile. Hey, Liberace, you must have a winning style. Since you have been on TV, my wife don't speak to me. In her dreams, it's Liberace. Oh, what you've done to me. Play, George. Liberace, you play piano and you sing. Hey, Liberace, you must have a certain thing. My mother-in-law came by to watch you on our TV set. But that was 30 weeks ago, and she ain't left here yet. Hey, Liberace, my wife is on the blink. Hey, Liberace, she swoons each time you wink. The women follow you around whenever you're in town. With your pearly teeth and your curly hair, you sure do get around. Pretty good, that fella. Gee, I wish I could sing like that. But since I can, I'll do the next best thing, and I'll play something I bet he can't play. Thank you. next part of the boogie woogie is so strange that I think it really calls for a little explanation. It's what they call a boogie woogie break. And just hearing it, you would think, as I played it, when I stop in a certain place, that I forgot the music. But I don't really forget the music. There just isn't any music written for that part. See? That's called a break. Every time I play that little part, it seems to bring out something out of certain people in the audience. And I bet if I played it again, you'd all like to try it. So I'm going to play it again. Go ahead, try it. Live dangerously. Fun. Let's try a little something now. Suppose just the ladies this time, all the girls by themselves, okay? Oh, that was terrific. Okay, fellas, now it's your turn. Terrific. You see, George, I told you, men do come to my concerts. Well, I certainly appreciate it, and I know somebody else who is real thrilled to find this out tonight, too, and that's my mom. Mom, I'll tell you what. Let the folks hear from you all by yourself this time, and I'll play it just for you. Okay, Mom? Oh, you're in the groove tonight, Mom. You know, I'd like to try something. You've been so nice about joining in this number. I've been playing this boogie-woogie with only 8 beats to the bar. I'd like to try a little invention now that has 16 beats to the bar. Gentlemen, I may be giving you folks the impression that here in America we only like music of a rhythmic nature, but I found this to be not true at all, because we made a very wonderful discovery through our phonograph recordings that our best-selling records to date have been the records of a religious nature. And so I would like to express in our music now our particular faith in playing for you a composition called The Rosary. Thank you. Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen. I know it's getting kind of late out, but you're not getting tired, are you? You're not? Because, you know what I enjoy doing? I love playing requests for people. What do you want to hear? I heard St. Louis Blues. Piano Roll Blues. NOLA. September Song. 12th Street Rag. Young at Heart, I heard someone say. I better get started. Okay. Bumble Boogie, I'll throw that in too, sure. You know what's fun, ladies and gentlemen, is rather than to stop in between each number, just sort of blend them all together. With your permission, I'd like to call this group of melodies you've requested the Hollywood Bowl Concerto. I'm kind of anxious to hear it. Young man courting the girls, I played me a waiting game. If a maid refused me with tossing curls, I'd let the older take a couple of whirls. For as time went along, she came my way. As time went along, she came. But it's a long, long while from May till December, and the days grow short when you reach September. The autumn weather turns the leaves to flame, and I haven't got time for the waiting game. For the days dwindle down to a precious few. September, November, and the ladies and gentlemen, this is about the tempo I always used to play the 12th Street Rag. But as time went on, everything else seemed to be going faster, so I decided the 12th Street Rag should go faster too. And as a result of that, Mr. Robert Ripley referred to it once in his Believe It or Not. He said there were 6,000 notes in this new arrangement that are played in less than 2 minutes' time. And the only reason I mention it to you is because I thought you might get a kick out of counting the notes.
Thank you.